Well, how many times have you heard an elected official say government needs to operate more like a business and spend tax money more carefully?
Well, tonight we question how careful and businesslike our state government is when it comes to paying state lawmakers for the work they do. Bill O'Neill joins us now with that story. Bill?
Guys, the average lawmaker earns more than $20,000 a year. But when the General Assembly meets in Raleigh, they can collect another $104 each day for meals and lodging. Well, we found that some lawmakers collect that money whether they show up for work or not.
State records show that lawmakers collected nearly $5,100 in subsistence money for the short session, which ran from mid-May until the beginning of July. Representative Larry Wobble took the money despite missing most of the session. The Forsyth County Democrat missed 21 of the 29 days that lawmakers met in Raleigh because of a car accident, an accident that badly injured Womble and killed the driver of the other car.
The accident explains Womble's absence from Raleigh, but when we asked him about taking the money for meals and lodging that he never paid for himself, he declined comment.
The rules, as stated in the general statutes, says the subsistence money or allowance is for, quote, meals and lodging while the General Assembly is in session. The legislative manual says that lawmakers can stop the money by filing a waiver. Otherwise, the money comes automatically. No receipts are needed like most businesses would require.
And for lawmakers who live 50 miles or more from Raleigh, the money is tax-free.
Over time, some legislators might begin to believe that that's just part of their compensation.
Elon Law School professor Howard Katz says the rules require lawmakers to conduct state business in order to collect the subsistence money.
You know, I think that anyone who's in a position of public trust, I think, has to be very careful about pushing the boundaries of any rule.
We found other local lawmakers who missed several days of the short session while still collecting the subsistence money. Davidson County Republican Jerry Dockham missed 5 days. Dockham, who's currently recovering from knee replacement surgery, says, quote, I don't think there's any abuse of the system. If I were going to miss a couple of weeks, then I wouldn't accept the subsistence money. In the Senate, Forsyth County Democrat Linda Guru missed 11 days, while Guilford County Democrat Gladys Robinson missed 6 days. Both women accepted the money for those missed days. Guru did not return our call for comment. Robinson gave us an interview. She blames her absence on a death in the family, but says the $104 per diem that she collected helps to make up for the low salary North Carolina lawmakers earn.
You see this as a supplement to the salary.
Well, what it is, it's a total package.
Senator Robinson says the extra money makes it possible for those who might not otherwise have the means to run for public office.
It ought to be equitable, so it affords people like me who work for a nonprofit, people who are on the streets, or whoever wants to run, the opportunity to represent their community.
Tax records show that Senator Robinson earned more than $100,000 last year operating a Greensboro nonprofit. Greensboro College political scientist Rebecca Clay says that lawmakers are held to a higher standard, especially when it comes to handling public money.
That they have responsibilities. They have responsibilities to do what's best for the public. That's a deal they sign on to when they run for office.
At least 13 state lawmakers agree they waived one or more days of subsistence money during the last session, including High Point Republican John Faircloth.
My feeling is that per diem is to compensate us for our expenses while we're there to perform the state's business. And if for some reason I couldn't be there for that purpose, I shouldn't take the money.
General Assembly was in session for 138 days over the past 2 years, and that means that lawmakers had a chance to collect an extra $14,000 in subsistence pay, and that is tax-free money for many of them. Guys, you know, there was one lawmaker down in Wake County. His name is Greer Martin. He did not accept a single dime of the subsistence pay during the last session. Now, you realize he lives in the Raleigh area, but there are plenty of other lawmakers who live in the Triangle area, all of whom took the subsistence money.
All right. Thanks a lot, Bill.
You bet.